Thank you very much, Chair. My name is Musa. When disaster strikes, the least prepared the community is, the most damage it causes. Surprises are always greater for the unprepared. The quality of response is directly proportional to the level of readiness. Epidemics can reach disastrous proportions when there is poor preparation and weak or uncoordinated response. And the last one is to fail to prepare is to prepare to fail. We use these ones when we are training the district rapid response teams from the IDSR strategy. Well, that is the presentation outline. Yeah, is that we need to appreciate the outbreaks that we have had in the past 12 years in Uganda. We have had Ebola and Marburg. Those are the years there. And she has mentioned each and everything here that shouldn't worry with the family. And then the reservoirs, I heard her mentioning about the forest dwelling bats, food bats. That was the objective. We review the epidemiology of the 2012 outbreaks in Uganda to inform interventions for disease prevention and control within the context of IDSR and of course the IHR. The rapid response teams are deployed to investigate and initiate the response. And of course, while we're doing this, we use the standard and working case definitions. And of course, samples were collected. And what is important here, we did our contact tracing and we made sure that we kept our data properly. These are just pictures. This is one of the things we thought that was key, enhancing local response capacities. That's why today we have gone ahead to train the district team, and we have built capacity in them in order to detect and respond to whatever conditions are there timely. This is maybe probably the gist of everything, where we had a 16-year-old, and this was in Kibale. You can see the onset of the illness. This was at about June 12th, and then subsequently admitted to the hospital, but she was not isolated. And then she was discharged, and immediately she got in contact with the in-laws and so on. And then you can see here that she died. This was very sad, but we couldn't do a lot because it happened before we had built capacity at the district level. And of course, they had the barriers which were not supervised. Those were just, it's the same thing in Luwero. You can see here, this time it was a male. This is just the village, sub-county, and so on. So on October 13th, that is when there was an onset of the illness. And then the treatment was subsequent at a certain health center. And then from here, the patient was referred to, this is called the General Military Hospital, somewhere in Bombo. On this date, you can see the period between here and this is about 7 days. And then the death occurred here. And the same thing, the barrier was not, it was not supervised. So these are just the summaries, basically. The cases of Ebola in Luwero, we just focus here on the total. Luwero, we had 7, and in Kibale we had 24. And the deaths, out of the 7, we had 4. And here, out of the 24, we had 17. So the CFR, you can see down here. For Chivalry, where it was nearly half. This is just the epidemic curve for the Chivalry, just to make us appreciate how we did our analysis from person, place, and time. And that is for Luwero. And of course, one of the things we focused on, since we are running our analysis by person, if you look at the age here, Ebola distribution by sex. You can see what happens. 80% of the probable confirmed cases in Chivari were what? We are all females. We were yet to determine why. And then that was the case distribution by age. Thank you, Chair. Majority, 46 to 86% of the cases were between 20 and 39 years of age. These are the same things that Dr. Monica has mentioned, this, the common symptoms. But for purposes of us appreciating this presentation, this is just a map, a hotspot where the Ebola of Chivari occurred, somewhere around here. And you can see the neighbors here. We have Matari, Abramite, and so on. So really, we did a lot of work here to make sure that we interrupt the transmission. Now this one is for Marburg. The same approach is the one we used. You can see she came from a village called Kafunzo, and on the 20th, that is where there was the onset. Of course, she visited the traditional birth attendants and so on. You know, they have a tendency of saying they have been bewitched. And this was the result, death, around the 20th of September. But you can see the period in here. We also had some laxity in responding to this. Those are just the cases. In Kabale, there were 14. Nibanda, there were also 14. But the deaths in Kabale, there were 7. And in Ibanda, there were 8. This is just as well the epidemic curve. And then this is also trying to show us by sex. The majority, 60 to 69%, were also females. By age, you can see majority, 50% of the cases were between 20 to 39 years. And these are the common symptoms that we found out. It was not identified. The Marburg outbreak was linked to mining activity in Chitaka. Recommendations. As I come to the end, surveillance for this should be enhanced, which we are doing. Right now we are conducting what we call IDSR trainings nationally. We have strengthened the clinical and laboratory diagnostic capacities for specimen referral at all levels. We do regional hub capacity building as well. Surveillance for clusters of strange illness or death at the community level is also one of the recommendations. And then research into the ecology is key. Last week, I happened to have been in Nakaseke, and I visited one of the nearby, I didn't want to call it a forest, but the forest-dwelling fruit bats are there. And these people are in the season of harvesting mangoes. So they are simply sharing the fruits with these bats, and they are enjoying very well. So maybe we need to do something there. Then regulation of mining activities in Western Uganda. Acknowledgement, Ministry of Health, the District Local Government, World Health Organization, Center for Disease Control, AFNET, and the others. Please don't be offended if I have not mentioned, but because of time constraints, thank you very much.